date?
Sure.
No.
Good evening. I am Walter Blunt. I'm sure you're all aware of last night's incident when I was arrested on charges including soliciting and drunk driving.
I'm going to start by saying congratulations on the show. I watched it the other night, and it's weird to... I was just laughing by myself in my hotel room. Oh. You know,
That's sad, isn't it?
It is. I wanted to watch with a group.
Yeah.
You know, I'm very curious for the both of you. Was this one of these projects that came together very quick? Was it a project that had been... You know what I mean? Talk a little bit about the genesis.
Couldn't have been quicker, from my point of view. I met Seth for lunch. I've been working with Seth for 9 years on American Dad. We met for lunch. It took 2 minutes. He said, I've had this idea. Well, how do you feel about doing a half-hour comedy show? For you? Yeah, sure. Done. I'm in. And then we talked about other things. It was that easy.
Right. But then, I mean, for Hollywood, I think it went fairly quickly. Seth proposed the idea to Patrick, would you like to do a comedy? Patrick says yes. Then Seth, he's so busy, he's like, I need an idea for the comedy, I need to find a writer. So that's where I came in, and I somehow came up with this idea of Patrick Stewart as a cable news host. I just thought he would look so formidable behind one of those desks and almost like something out of George Orwell. And so I got that idea. I give it to Seth. Seth's like, I like it. And I said, no, you know, we'll live behind the scenes with his nutty staff, and which could become like a family. Seth liked it. I met with Patrick. He liked the idea. And then I guess because of Hollywood, it seemed like it took about a year after that until I finally wrote the script. Now, once I wrote the script, probably April of 2014, then things moved very quickly. And by September, I had moved to LA, had a writing staff, and now was, you know, building the whole season. Then we were shooting by January 2015. So the whole thing took about 2 years, which in Hollywood terms, I think is kind of fast.
It's that's very fast.
Yeah.
Extremely. I'm very curious. One of the things I like is that Blunt is not a mean person. He really likes people, and he's good-hearted. He just is an interesting character. Mm-hmm. Was that one of the? Was there ever any talk about, you know, was that always the idea to keep him pretty? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, my, in general, in creating characters, I don't want the humor to come necessarily from mockery or derision. You know, I've often noticed, you know, when I would see other people's scripts or other shows, it's like, these people are supposed to be friends, but they're incredibly unkind to each other. So I like the characters, you know, they might give each other a hard time, but ultimately they're loving towards each other. You know what I mean? Which I think is more representative, I would hope, of how human beings are. And that's why I also want the comedy to, you know, be uplifting. You know, that we're rooting for these people because they are loving towards each other. They might be completely screwed up and a little bit lunatic and make bad decisions, but they are loving.
So. True or not true, you are basing Blunt on Pierce Morgan.
Poor Pierce. Oh, dear. I feel we should take out a full page in the New York Times and the LA Times and say, Pierce, it's not you. Please understand that. I've actually met with Pierce. We had breakfast together, and because the previous morning he'd yelled at me in the restaurant, you're playing me, what do you think you're doing? And so I reassured him that it wasn't him. He was wonderfully interesting and helpful, however, because he has been through exactly what Walter is experiencing right now, an Englishman working on an American news show. And he was marvelous and at times indiscreet, although that was in confidence, about his experiences. And some of them have been fed directly into the show.
I'm very curious for both of you. Has there been, when you think about filming the first season, is there a day or two that you will always remember, like memorable moments from filming, something that really stood out for you?
Well, there are many, but do you, a few come to mind. Are you ready to go?
Well, day one. We actually started with episode two, where a lot of the action takes place in a porn studio. I mean, where the movies are actually made. And so one of the first scenes that we shot on that day, there were semi-naked females in the background of the scene. And I have never had that experience before of acting with naked people, you know, and actually paying no attention to them, trying to pretend they're not there. That was a little memorable. Maybe it wouldn't have been for you, but
it it would have been memorable, without a doubt.
Yeah, I set that on a porn set. I had once, as a journalist, gone to a porn set to write about it, and my father happened to be visiting Los Angeles at the same time that I was on this journalistic assignment. So my dad, I knew, had an interest in pornography because in the 40s he used to show stag films, so he liked to say. So I brought him to the porn set. We were there for 3 hours. We stepped out into the light afterwards, and the first thing he said after what we had witnessed, which was not really very charming in any way, he said, "It was very dark in there. I could have tripped on a cable." That was his only comment, so that's why I put a cable and had someone trip on it in our episode. But what comes to my mind in shooting our show, we did some like really beautiful exteriors. We shot the Venice canals at night, Walter rowing and being rowed in a boat. We went out to the desert outside of Los Angeles. So Walter and Rosalie, played by Jacki Weaver, out in the desert in this beautiful landscape. We were on top of Griffith Park, overlooking the whole city. You know, we were in Hollywood by the Capitol Records building. So we did some really beautiful exterior work, and those nights kind of come to mind because it was a chance while making a half-hour comedy to get some big cinematic images.
Holy shit, Walter fucking Blunt!
Oh shit!
No, no! Oh.
I can't keep pretending that someone is on howling in pain nearby.
Walter's manservant is leeching his body of toxins.
Very unclean!
How's it looking, Major?
Just hold still. The sun is very specific at the moment.
The way that it's glinting off your bald spot, it's just like something out of the Renaissance.